Hello there, it's Sound and Vision ASMR, and I'm back for another video, the first video in a little while, but I'll talk a little bit more about that at the end. For now though, I'm going to be talking about telescopes today, and also using a soft-spoken voice instead of my usual whisper, just to mix things up a little bit. So, I recently acquired a telescope, which sadly I won't be showing you today, though I will post a little picture. Well, I'll put a little picture at the end of this video. But what I thought I'd do is show you a few of the things that came with it, that you can hopefully see here. Read a little bit about it from the instructions and tell you about it, and then look through this book here of up-and-coming stargazing events, which I hope to be observing with the telescope. So, I'll just move these out of the way. Some crinkly bags and things like that. I'll put these aside. Now, this is the user guide. My telescope is a Celestron 114mm, and it's 114EQ is the type. It's a Newtonian reflector. Now, I'm guessing if people have sort of searched for this video, you know about telescopes, but I'm going to presume, like I did before I started looking at telescopes, sort of zero knowledge. A Newtonian reflector is a type of telescope, as shown here, which uses mirrors to reflect the light. I'll see if I can find a diagram. Should be around here somewhere. It uses a mirror as a lens. Here we go. Light comes in through this section, then bounces off of this mirror, or reflects off the mirror, and then the actual eyepiece then reflects upwards out of the side of it, which may seem unusual to you, as the sort of telescope you imagine when you think of telescopes is the refractor design, which, as you can make out there, is just a long tube with a series of lenses which focus the light into the eyepiece at the end. That's just that long thing where you look at the end and up out for it. But my one is the reflector design. It means that it can be more compact because it can only be sort of half the length, but it's also wider. What else can I say? Another thing to note is it's on an equatorial mount, which means that instead of just sort of pointing it at things, well, you can still point at things, but it's based on a coordinate system using sort of two axes. And instead of being just up and down, which wouldn't be very useful in the night sky, it uses two variables called, I'm only just learning this myself, but I think it's declination and right ascension. I'm sure people will correct me if I get these wrong, but I'm not sure which way around, but they're the sort of various ways axis is axes in which you can rotate about, which by rotating one of them you can track an object as it moves across the night sky, as obviously it's moving with the Earth's rotation. Like I said, the telescope is sort of about that long and that wide, so I couldn't really show it to you, and also it doesn't create any interesting sounds, really. It's just a big long tube of metal and plastic, so it would have been awkward to film and sort of get good views off and just a bit clunky. So instead, I thought I'd show you some of the bits that go with it. So, here I have two eyepieces, one in this container and one in this bag. I have a moon filter and just a standard lens cloth. So let's have a little show off. This is the first eyepiece. Now, although the mirrors and the inside of the telescope captures the light, it's the eyepiece that does the magnification, allowing you to sort of see, you know, the whole point of the telescope is see large sort of clear objects that you can't see with the naked eye. So that's what these parts do. So I'm going to venture into the world of ASMR triggers now and do some bag sounds as I talk to you about it. I have the microphone up, sort of by my mouth up here. As you can see, I'm sort of sitting sort of awkwardly on the floor. So it's just sealed off in this plastic bag. This one didn't come with a little pot like this one. So it came in a bag to keep it protected instead. I'll open it up, I suppose. It's one of those seal sort of lock bags that you... little plasticky container. Now this is the least powerful eyepiece. It is a 20mm erecting lens. Oh, sorry, erecting eyepiece. It's got a little lens cap here, which I'll just get off gently. Now, I don't know how this will look, but I can try and show it to the camera there. I don't know how well it'll focus onto it, but it's a sort of long eyepiece which inserts into the hole in the telescope, and you can see this is the end where you look through, and it's got a big 2cm diameter sort of a lens in there, and equally you can look through the other way. You see the front bit. Now this is the eyepiece that's used sort of when you're first homing in on an object in the sky. It's sort of the least magnifications of it, just to get the general image of it. I'm not exactly sure how it works. Maybe someone can help me out, really, if anyone knows about telescopes. But it's an erecting lens, which I believe means that it corrects the image somewhat. I know there's certain orientation kind of things that goes on due to how the telescope works. The mirror obviously inverts the image somewhat. So I think something in here, in this long sort of housing at the back, does something to correct that and make the image you see through the eyepiece possibly sort of the right way up. Not that you really notice it that much in the sky unless you know certain, like the surface of the moon, unless you know it well, you wouldn't be able to tell whether it was sort of right way up, inverted, or, you know, you just couldn't tell. How are we on? How are we for time? Okay. What I might do is stop this video and then restart it, because this camera has that 20-minute limit I think I've mentioned before. But anyway, this is the second eyepiece. It comes in a sort of rubbery plastic pot. make some little jingly things here. Have to be more careful with this one, as it doesn't actually come with a cap. I think the fact that it comes in a case makes up for that. This is a 10mm eyepiece. So the sort of lens in there is actually smaller, but that of course focuses the light more at a sort of steeper angle, if you will, providing more magnification. This one's interesting as it has a, I've forgotten the word, but that sort of coils in the middle to screw things into, which I'll show you a bit later with the moon filter, becomes important. But it's a similar design. You've got the eye sort of rubbery bit here, and then a lens going through. Hopefully you can see through the centre there. I don't know if you can sort of see through that very well. You might be able to. You might be able to see my hand sort of through the end there. So that's the more powerful one, once you've found what you're looking for with the 20mm one. You then insert this eyepiece and get more detail on the thing in the sky that you're looking for. Now, I think I've just about got time to show you this moon filter. Now, this I got separately. Again, it's in another plasticky bag that I'll make some crinkly sounds with. The moon filter is used, well, no prizes for guessing, it's used when viewing the moon. This is because the moon can be quite bright, especially when viewed through a telescope where it's focusing all that light onto your eye, and on a full moon that can be quite overpowering. So this is used, as you can see here. It's a sort of dark film of, I'm not sure if it's plastic or glass, or some sort of Pyrex most probably, but it cuts the light that's allowed through down to about, I think it's around 10 or 20%. So it just means that you can look at the moon for longer, and also sort of make out more details on the craters and things like that. Sort of reduces the contrast, I think you'd say. And that screws in, you can see the threading, that's the word I was looking for, that screws into the bottom of that 20mm eyepiece. Though at the moment I haven't found a way of connecting it to the 20mm one. So that's something I'm still working on. Maybe you just can't do it. Other than that, we have this in its bag, which just goes in this little plastic pot here, which I'll just make some noises with. As you can see, it's just a little pot I got to go and put the moon in, filter in it, just to keep it safe, as it just came in this little crinkly bag. It's just a little plastic pot that makes some quite nice sounds. Other than that, we have this little lens cleaner, just standard, using it to wipe it. I'll finish, or at least wind up towards finishing, by talking about what I've seen. Let's check how we're doing on time. So far, I've observed the moon. Obviously, that's quite simple, but I've seen all the craters, which is amazing, really, for the first time, seeing all that detail on what's normally just a kind of white circle with, you can make out some details, but with the telescope you can just see all the separate craters and the bumps sort of on the edge. It's quite amazing. I'm just wondering what to do with the time. I think I'll end it here. then in just a moment, I'll make another video telling you about things coming up, which I'll be uploading in a few days' time. So a bit strange, it's recorded at the same time, but I need to get down to editing both of them. So you've seen all my equipment and lenses, and next I'll tell you about what you can see in the sky and what I've seen in the sky. So see you then. Thanks for watching. And yes, comment any questions or any answers to any of the questions I've said, really. See you next time. Goodbye.